Another pay-per-view, another time you walking out as the WWE champion. However, tonight some may say it was a little Martin controversy. What do you have to say about that?
Well, who says it was controversial? You? Who are you? You just somebody else who wants to disrespect me? You know what the controversy was? The controversy was that I had to beat somebody twice. I didn't sign up for a 2 out of 3 falls match. I signed up for a triple threat. And I wind up having to fight 4 people. John Cena, Big Show, and little AJ, who obviously has it out for me. So Big Show taps out. And I gotta restart the match and I gotta beat him again. What do? I beat him again. You know, and people now want to say that's controversial. Why is it controversial? Because somebody who AJ doesn't want to be champion is champion? No? Is that what's controversial about it? Well, come on. You ask the questions, but you got no answers.
No,
just the fact
that the match had to be restarted, and it was a possibility that you might not have come out as the champion.
You know what the controversy is? The controversy is why the champion, somebody who's been champion for 10 months, has to beat somebody twice in a single match. What else you want to throw at me? You know what? You see this? Does everybody out there see this? Whether you like it or whether you hate it, you better learn to respect it.
Raw, and speaking of controversy, CM Punk, many people say, retained the WWE Championship in a controversial manner last night. And one person who really took exception to this, the former WWE Champion, a 10-time WWE Champion, John Cena.
John, you came up short tonight for the WWE Championship.
Yeah.
Are you willing to say at this point that CM Punk is the best in the world?
Man, he's sure lucky. What a night. I don't think I've ever seen anything like that in my career here. I'm not going to blame tonight on a referee missing a call or certainly a general manager. That's not going to do me any good. It's just one of those nights, man. I hate to be that guy, but I'll try to get him tomorrow.
As strange as the night was, again, CM Punk did come out victorious. Is there any way to say that he is the best in the world?
I don't know what you want from me, man. I'll tell you what, I'll talk to you tomorrow.
Ladies and gentlemen, I give you the WWE Champion, CM Punk.
That's right, still WWE Champion CM Punk, but now the question remains, who is my next opponent? Pretty much beat everybody. I gotta right now thank AJ Lee, the general manager of Raw, for having the respect enough for her champion to allow me to choose my next opponent. And I wanna choose somebody that the WWE Universe loves. Somebody that can take a beating like a man. Somebody that the WWE Universe looks up to. Somebody a lot of people say that I can't beat. My next opponent is John Cena. On one condition, and I'll call out John Cena later tonight in the ring and see if he's man enough to accept based on this one condition. Because, man, it's all about respect. Respect from you, my fellow superstars. Respect from the WWE Universe. I command respect when I walk into a room. And tonight, I'm going to demand respect from John Cena.
You know, after defending my title at SummerSlam last night, I was just gonna come out here and talk about my next contender for the championship, and then I saw you sitting here and I remembered a couple weeks ago how you said...
I think CM Punk has turned on the WWE Universe.
Let's just clear the air right now. I want you to go ahead and admit that was a lie. Have the respect for me. Couldn't have waited. You heard me earlier tonight say that I was going to call you out here to talk about being number one contender, but you still had to come out here to steal the spotlight. I've been taking a backseat to you out of respect. But respect, it's a two-way street. The title shot is yours at Night of Champions, John Cena. All you have to do is hear live in front of everybody. Admit that I am the best in the world. Just tell the truth, John.
Maybe throwing away a chance at a championship, but I am not going to call you the best in the world. Because to succeed, I have to believe every night in my heart of hearts that I am the best. Because if the day comes when you don't believe in yourself, there's the door. Get the hell out. Night of Champions is in my hometown. if you walk in the Night of Champions, the WWE Champion, against me and leave the WWE Champion, that is the moment that will define your existence. The choice is yours. Choose anybody. But don't come out here and demand respect, because if you don't choose me for the biggest match in the main event of Night of Champions, you got no respect for that and no respect for you.
Jerry Lawler, let's finish it once and for all. Before I was really interrupted, I demanded an apology. I want an apology right now.
This is all a misunderstanding, but if that's what you want, I apologize.
Jerry, I'm not finished. If Cena doesn't want to say it, you're the minister of propaganda to the WWE Universe. They're going to buy what you're selling. I want to hear you say that I am the best in the world.
I can't say that.
Disrespecting me. I won't be disrespected by anybody.
I am the WWE Champion. Show some respect.
Now, I know that this is not the way Monday Night Raw normally starts, but I got something that I really need to get off my chest. As we went off the air on the 1,000th edition of Raw, I made a remark that CM Punk later described as a derogatory remark, and I admitted that I may have misspoke. So last week when CM Punk came out here and demanded that I get in the ring and apologize to him, I thought, out of respect for the WWE Championship, it's no big deal. So I came in the ring, I apologized to CM Punk, after which I got kicked in the head from behind. So last week, I apologized to CM Punk. This week, I want an apology from CM Punk.
What? You want the WWE Champion to apologize for doing his job? On the 1,000th episode of Raw, you said, and I quote, CM Punk is just turned his back on the WWE Universe. Because I justifiably beat the crap out of The Rock. And I say justifiably because he showed me a gross lack of respect. And then you somehow want to sit in your little chair and paint me as a bad guy? I'm not a bad guy. And I didn't turn my back on anybody. You, Jerry Lawler, turned your back on the WWE Universe when you slandered its beloved champion. And it's because of your lack of respect that I kicked you in your stupid head. Okay, don't get it twisted. I didn't attack you from behind. I didn't ambush you. I didn't kick you in the back of your head. You tried to leave my ring and you pushed me out of the way, and then you got socked in the head. That's what I do. I will put down anybody who shows me disrespect. But as far as your apology goes, I'm a man. I'll apologize in front of the world. I am sorry, Jerry Lawler. I'm sorry that all it takes to get in the WWE Hall of Fame is to beat a bunch of nobodies from Memphis, to get into a slap fight with a Hollywood comedian, to act like a juvenile, infantile 14-year-old for your entire 23-year career here in WWE. I'm sorry that your jealousy and lack of respect for me stems from never being WWE champion yourself. And I'm sorry that when you finally got your big WrestleMania moment, you couldn't beat Michael Cole. I'm sorry I'm raising my voice right now, and I'm sorry that you've become the WWE's circus seal, ready to regurgitate and repeat any stupid opinion that's barked into your ear. Most of all, I'm sorry about the man you've become. Are you upset? Did that upset you? Did I touch a nerve? You look like you want to fight. You want to fight me, Jerry Lawler? You're just a commentator. I'm the best in the world. And everybody here knows, because they paid to see me, that I would embarrass you. I would embarrass you.
I came out here for an apology, not a fight.
I know that. I hear the words. You're not asking for a fight, but I can see it on your face. I can tell in your body language. You're getting all tensed up. You want to bow up because you want to fight. But honestly, what do you think would happen if you fought me? I'm the WWE champion. If I'm not the best in the world, Jerry, then who is? Are you? Are you the best? You want to find out? Because I'll fight you. I'll promise you one thing's gonna happen at the end of tonight. You're gonna leave embarrassed. I'll leave it up to you how embarrassed you're gonna leave. You're either gonna leave embarrassed because I'm gonna beat you with an inch of your life, or you're gonna leave embarrassed because you wouldn't fight me. Decision's yours, King. Think about it.
I want to bring you up to date on a tweet that CM Punk sent out moments ago. It says, and I quote, "I know he's just a commentator, so to help him decide if at Jerry Lawler is man enough to fight me, I'll let him have the first punch. Hashtag respect." So there you go. So what's it going to be? Are you going to fight? Are you going to battle CM Punk here tonight on Monday Night Raw? It's in your court. Jerry?
You know, CM Punk came out here and said that I beat up a bunch of nobodies down in Memphis, Tennessee. Well, let me tell you something, Punk. Those nobodies that I beat up down in Memphis, Tennessee include names like Jesse the Body Ventura, Harley Race, Jack Briscoe, Superstar Billy Graham, Bill Dundee, Dutch Mantel. The list goes on. And I can tell you this, Punk. I don't know how long you would have lasted down in Memphis, Tennessee, pal. Now, he also said that sometimes out here I act like a fun-loving 14-year-old. That may be true. He also said I've never been WWE champion. That's true. He said I beat up a comedian down in Memphis. Well, you know what? That comedian was one of the greatest comedians ever from Hollywood that I had a lot of respect for. His name was Andy Kaufman. Now, the one thing you did say, Punk, about me is that I am a WWE Hall of Famer. And you don't get in the WWE Hall of Fame unless you stand up when the time is right. Unless you summon the guts to stand up to somebody who's younger than you, somebody who's in the prime of their life. Now, CM Punk, I know I'm not the best in the world, but I don't think you are either. So I've never backed down on a challenge in my life, and I am not gonna start tonight. So you wanna know, Punk, if I'll fight you, you damn right I'll fight you tonight.
Cena with the five knuckles shuffle to Miz. Now it's time for the AA. And he connects. Cena. The time is up, my Cena with a win, but Miz very game here tonight.
Again, aggressive nature from the Miz, just not enough to overcome the power and strength of John Cena here tonight on Monday Night Raw.
John Cena victorious over the Miz. Nonetheless, Miz will lead as the Intercontinental Champion. Ladies and gentlemen, we are receiving breaking news as we speak from the office of General Manager AJ Lee concerning our main event tonight, CM Punk versus Jerry the King Lawler. From what we understand, Raw is about to get Raw active once again. AJ Lee telling us that the WWE Universe is going to have the opportunity to choose the type of match we want to see Punk and Lawler compete in here tonight as Cena continues to celebrate. So again, General Manager AJ Lee going to let you, the WWE Universe, decide what type of matchup Punk and Lawler will be in tonight on Monday Night Raw.
Yeah, it is a Raw active Twitter poll, and AJ Lee, our General Manager, is giving you three choices. We want to use the hashtag WWE tables if you want to see these two compete in a tables match. Use hashtag WWE cage for a steel cage match, or hashtag WWE no, and then the letters DQ for a no disqualification match for our main event tonight between WWE Champion CM Punk and Jerry the King Lawler.
Well, I thought things were bleak for Jerry the King Lawler, but now looking at these stipulations, King may be thinking twice about accepting this matchup here tonight. Well, also tonight, well, Triple H will be here live, and he will discuss his future here in the WWE. Of course, this all happened.
I appreciate the fact that you're back here. And I know I've always had your respect, but you've got to respect the fact that tonight, I need to face CM Punk and beat him on my own. I mean, John, if you interfere in this match, that's just one more thing that Punk will have to throw in my face, that Lawler couldn't beat CM Punk without John Cena's help. You gotta understand, I'm not fighting CM Punk for John Cena. I'm fighting CM Punk for myself.
Good luck, King.
Thanks.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's now time to unveil the results of the Raw Active Twitter poll in regards to tonight's main event match between WWE Champion CM Punk and WWE Hall of Famer Jerry the King Lawler. The results are in. We asked you to use different hashtags for different stipulations, be it a tables match, a steel cage match, or a no disqualification match. The tweets are in. Here's what you, the WWE Universe, voted on.
Overwhelmingly.
So there you have it.
Regardless of the outcome of tonight's steel cage match, CM Punk will defend his WWE title at Night of Champions against my choice. John Cena.
I like that. Punk, the Anaconda Vice. The Vice locked in. Submission maneuver. And Lawler's got to tap out. He's got no choice. CM Punk proved his point. But now Punk, now he's got to let him go. He's got to let Lawler go here. Punk proved his point.
Yeah, but release.
I mean, the Vice is still locked in. The referee is finally.
The winner of this match is the Golden Bay Submission. The WWE Champion, CM Punk.
CM Punk did what he wanted to do tonight. He taught Jerry Lawler, in his mind, something about respect. He claimed Lawler a disrespected him a number of weeks ago when Lawler claimed Punk could turn his back on the WWE Universe. But give credit here tonight to Jerry the King Lawler for accepting this fight, accepting this match with CM Punk. Matchup is long over.
There you go.
Just the facts, Jerry Lawler. Just the facts. I know you have one arm, but your mouth works just fine. So tonight, I give you another shot. I want to hear you say that I'm the best in the world. Say it!
Hell no!
The best wrestler in the world, and I want to hear you say it. Say it! Say it!
Just say it. And there's John Cena. John Cena coming down here, and somebody's got to help Lawler.
Get the cage up!
Get that cage up. I am the best wrestler in the world. Sheamus, don't come out here and try to talk to my hometown. They can't relate to a guy like you. They can relate to a guy like me because I'm from here. How's everybody doing? What you saw a little bit earlier was me beating up Jerry Lawler. But what the cameras did not catch was Jerry attacking me from behind. See, there's only one king in Chicago, and when you come at the king, you best not miss. Jerry Lawler just got exactly what he deserved, and he got it Chicago style. It's not bad enough that Jerry Lawler needs to attack me from behind. For weeks, he's sat at his desk and he's attacked my integrity. And I think everybody here knows that's something you do not do. So I last week in a cage, I decided to take it upon myself to teach Jerry a little bit of a lesson in respect. And class was in session until a little white knight decided to come and stick his nose where it didn't belong. That white knight's name is John Cena. See, I did to Jerry Lawler what he deserved, because on the Raw 1000th episode, he famously stated that I turned my back on the WWE Universe. So I ask of the universe, did I turn my back on you? John Cena, you helped Jerry Lawler, and when you helped Jerry Lawler, it means you agree with Jerry Lawler. And if you agree with Jerry Lawler, that means you disagree with me. And if you disagree with me, that means you're disrespecting me. And where I come from, you do not disrespect the best in the world. And if you choose to foolishly disrespect the WWE Champion for 288 days, well then, John Cena, it's you who's turned your back on the WWE Universe. Sheamus, I already beat up one goon tonight. I don't think tonight's your night. I have nothing to do with you. Yeah, you're the World Heavyweight Champion, but guess what, fella? That makes you, at best, the second best in the world. Aww. And comes with that a pecking order. And in that pecking order, you're right behind me, so shut your mouth.
No disrespect, Punk. And no disrespect, Sheamus. But I have an announcement to make. Night of Champions is less than 2 weeks away. What just gave me an idea for tonight's two main events. In one match, the challengers for the world title and the WWE title will face each other, which means Alberto Del Rio will face John Cena. And the other main event is going to be a champion versus champion match. Which means world champ Sheamus will face WWE champ CM Punk.
Sweet home Chicago. See, Sheamus, there's a lot that you don't know about my city. The first being, they respect me and my decisions. This city really gets it. They understand that a WWE champion against a World Heavyweight Champion is nothing less than a WrestleMania main event. They understand that CM Punk is nothing less than a main event wrestler. Listen to him. This place respects the fact that you just don't parade CM Punk out at the 8 o'clock hour and exploit the fact that he happens to be from Chicago. They respect that, and they respect all my decisions. And besides, it's Labor Day. There's a lot of people here that have probably taken the day off of work. That's why I'm sure they're all going to respect the fact that I'm doing the same thing.
Wait, what are you doing? Okay, you can't leave, okay? You have a match.
I can't leave?
No.
Check the deal, bro. Check my contract. I got personal days. Today's one of them.
Excuse me, AJ? AJ, what are you going to do about your main event?
Who are you? I said, who are you? Whoever you are, just do me a favor. Go tell Sheamus to stay in the ring. I will find him an opponent.
Cena going for the attitude adjustment. Oh! Out of those equipment cases.
Oh! Cena Punk's back!
Punk's back!
Punk's back!
Punk with another ambush tonight!
What happened to his personal day?
This one to Cena! Now he's helping Del Rio. And Del Rio into the cover.
Two,
falls
three,
count anywhere.
Three.
Del Rio is defeated Cena.
And the winner of this match,
El Perro del Rio.
Respect.
Handle this one. Yes, he called you a phony. Does that irritate you? Does that make you want to come down here and maybe do something about it? If that's the case, I'm calling you a phony too. Two things happen at this point. You either stay up there or you come in here, and there's 40 feet of distance and three ropes between you and the worst decision of your life.
Well, if that isn't the pot calling the kettle black, I don't know what is. It's quite ironic. The biggest phony in world wrestling entertainment history decides to point his finger and cast judgment on its champion. Well, John Boy, I don't need your judgment and I don't need your permission. I do what I want. I do what I decide. And right now I've decided to come out here and defend my good name in the face of such rampant, ridiculous disrespect. It almost breaks my heart to see the two of you standing in the ring together. It makes me realize, wow, the Hitman and John Cena are so much alike. And trust me, that's not a compliment. You two can sit here and pat each other on the back and have a little powwow and talk about how great the both of you were at being the top guy and completely neglect to mention the fact that you were both unceremoniously surpassed by somebody far superior than yourselves. John, in your instance, I of course am speaking of me. And Hitman, in your case, obviously, I'm talking about Shawn Michaels. And by the way, you can't draw a line of comparison between CM Punk and Shawn Michaels, not the old Shawn, not the new Shawn, because I am better than Shawn Michaels. Oh, hey, Brett, Hitman, you remember that hillbilly you made pass out to your little sharpshooter at WrestleMania 13? Stone Cold Steve Austin? I'm better than him, too. And I'm better than The Rock. I mean, we all said, we all knew, and we all saw what I did to him in one night when he showed me one iota of disrespect. Hell, John, boy, I did in one night what you couldn't do in an entire calendar year. I am the best wrestler. I am the best talker. I am the best technician. I am the best brawler. And I don't say these things from a place of insecurity, and I apologize for your lack of self-confidence, but I say it because I am it. And that makes me anything but a phony.
He's right. Because that last statement actually makes you a liar, a hypocrite, and a conceited scumbag. Congratulations! You can also add that to your resume. You know, listening to these people tonight, I realize that Montreal is a very honest city. For years, WWE has referred to this building as Bizarro World. Quite frankly, you folks are just honest. You tell us how you feel, whether it's something that we want to hear or not. Tonight, I'm going to take a lesson from Montreal and actually hit you in the face with a dose of truth, whether you want to hear it or not. For 300 days, you have been WWE champion. For 300 days, that championship has been irrelevant. Month after month, you watch main event by main event pass you by, and your excuse is that there's some sort of weird political conspiracy against you. But the fact is, there is no you. You see, you have been here for many, many, many years, and the night you made the most noise was ironically the night your microphone was turned silent. Ah. I remember those days. Talk about change. Passionate, convicting talk of change. And then one triumphant night in Chicago when you were the victor and the universe finally said, we get change. And they were lied to. They were fooled into a false claim, because change was not ice cream bars, change was not edgy television, change wasn't even new talent. All you meant by we want change is make CM Punk a star. You don't even know who CM Punk is. I remember in those rants that you once said that I'd become what I despise in reference to success. No. I went from an underdog to an odds-on favorite but I did it as me. Through all of this, the wins, the losses, the championships, the year when I didn't win the big one in WrestleMania, the embarrassment, the humility, I've had to stand on my own two feet and do it as me. And then there's you. You have changed your ideology numerous times. You have stabbed your friends in the back. You borrow colors from Hall of Famers. You steal the elbow of the late Randy Savage. All because you have yet to find you. I'm not saying you're not tough. I've been in the ring with you. And I'm not saying you're not accomplished. But your latest phase of development revolves around this. You think because you have this, you are justified respect. No, the reason you have that and have kept it is by any means necessary, and that does not define a champion in my eyes. So at Night of Champions, you're going to have to search for a new identity. You've been really, really loud these past weeks because you finally realize at Night of Champions, you are in serious jeopardy of losing this. I didn't want to do this, but the city of Montreal has kind of owed me a favor, so I'm going to pay one back to you. I'm a little rusty. Mais je parle un petit français. CM Punk parlait les grandes victoires avec la nuit du champion, mais je vais te botter le cul. Which means
you have lowered yourself. You have lowered yourself to their level, to speak their language, to speak the language of the locals. You have lowered yourself.
Enough! Enough! Listen up, Jack. I don't lower myself to them because they are the reason we are here. And you need a little bit of respect. So, in English, what I said was, you say you're gonna win at Night of Champions, but I'm just gonna kick your ass.